was about 10:45 ish, and I'm going to head over towards Harlech, which is about an hour and a half, hour and three quarters drive. I have no idea which way this is going to take me. It's 62 miles, but it's not main road, unfortunately, all the way, or fortunately, whatever you want to look at it. Get there. It's cramping up a little bit. There's an awful lot of traffic on the road. See how we end up. I've got my new custom fit guards fitted today. They arrived in the post yesterday. It's taken over 5 weeks, and they've been ready since the 7th of April, and all they said they were waiting for was a pouch to send them in, which I find a bit extreme, but I'm jury's out, shall we say. See how they get on. I went for the total block, and even they aren't the quietest. I'm getting wind noise with the visor just on its first click. I'm getting a bit of wind noise, more than I would expect to get on total block. And I opted for the lanyard, which is an extra £15. And all it is a bit of string. Bit of string, that's all it is. Bit of string. £15. So I don't see how that can be justified, quite honestly. The little pouch that it came in is exactly the same as the pouch that I bought off eBay for something else that I was using, and I paid 99 pence on eBay including postage, and they charge £5.95 at custom guards. Again, that's a bit of a rip-off. Whether the guards are any good, let us say the jury's still out, we'll see after today. But I've got the windscreen on its lowest setting, so, which is what I'd normally ride with, my ordinary sponge earplugs. But yeah, to have a bit of paracord fitted to them seems a bit of a rip-off. £15. Quite honestly, when I put the earplugs in the first at the first, every time I moved the cord, you could hear the rustle, having the telephone effect, and it went straight to my ears, so you could hear the rustling of the clothing on your lanyard, if you want to call it that. Now I'm on the bike, I'm not listening, not hearing any of that, so that's one good thing. This is taking me through Penavont and over the mountain, I guess. So the only thing about them is they're secure. They're not popping up my ear as my sponge ones very often did. But they're no better than my sponge ear guards, if I'm truthful, so far. Travelling at normal rural road or urban road speeds, 50, 60 miles an hour, I'm still getting wind noise. I put the windscreen up a little bit. That's it, only up a fraction. Wind noise is completely gone, but that's the windscreen doing that, not the ear guards. So at the moment we're just heading out towards Llangedwin, and we'll be on to Penavont very shortly. Bumpy old road this. It can have a lot of debris on it, but so far so good. River Tannock to my left. Little babbling brook at the moment, there's not much water in it. I just got a glimpse of it there through the hedge. So now we're in Pennebont. Slip there, a little bit of gravel. Gedwin. Surface wasn't good there, that put me out over the other side of the road. Need to watch that. Thank you. taken me over the mountain. Crossing over the River Tanet. Not much in it at the moment. Nice of you to stay on your own side of the road. This is quite a nasty junction. It's almost blind to the left. So I normally try to avoid coming this way, but I've no choice today. Yes, they definitely could have made this easier. And as always, a lot of gravel. There you are. Always a lot of gravel in that junction. Bent Vower. As I say, I very often come back this way. I don't normally come this way if I can avoid it. So we'll be going up over the mountain very shortly. To wave anymore, nod the heads, a lot of these, that's two of them have gone past so far, no nods. Oh my goodness, this is gravel. More gravel. In not too many minutes, we'll be heading over that bad boy. Don't go over here too quick, because you meet something on that bridge. Yep. This is the start of the mountain pass. There she is, in all her glory.